The Kogi State Government has again countered the National Center for Disease Control, NCDC's claims on the existence of coronavirus in the state, claiming that the alleged index case only suffered a bee sting. Kinsley Fowle, the Commissioner for Information and Communication in the state, said in a statement on Monday that the index case had been discharged without seeing his test results. The NCDC had on May 27 announced two index cases for Kogi. Abubakar Ahmed, the chief imam of Kaba, turned out to be one of the two index cases of the COVID-19 in the state. But the state government rejected the results after raising questions as to how the cases were handled, including the decision to manage the patients at the National Hospital in Abuja. Fowle accused the NCDC of plotting to announce a third case in the state through unverifiable processes.
The alleged third case of COVID-19 credited to Kogi State by the NCDC is shaping up to be another exercise in secrecy and unverifiable processes by the NCDC. Nearly 1 week after she was sneaked onto the NCDC list, the Kogi State government is yet to be armed with the actionable information she needs to take preemptive actions in line with the COVID-19 guidelines. We suspect that the NCDC's lackadaisical attitude may not be unconnected with the knowledge that no infection has been found. Just like in the case of the chief imam and his family, let it be known that we are looking out for our citizen and will demand full reckoning should any harm come to her. We make it clear once again that there is no case of COVID-19 in Kogi State. If ever there is, we will be the first to announce it while deploying all recommended protocols and procedures. Our people can rest assured that we will continue to work extra hard to make sure that this increasingly controversial disease does not come into our states.
Joining us now is the Commissioner for Information Kogi State himself, Kinsley Fowle. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Okay, just off that press briefing that you did, could you talk to us a bit about this lackadaisical attitude of the NCDC that you refer, especially in the light of all the commendation coming on behalf of the NCDC on the work that they've been doing with combating the spread of COVID-19?
Thank you very much. The whole process was fraught with a lot of fraud, and we had always said that they are beating their own protocol and procedures. The man that was taken to Abuja and celebrated by NCDC to have been infected with the COVID-19 virus was only treated for fever and some of the underlying ailments that he was nursing before, after which he was discharged. So it shows that even NCDC knew it, that the man had no malaria, and that was why they did not even try to manage any COVID-19. They only treated fever and discharged the man. So he had no COVID-19. And we are demanding from NCDC that they should remove Kogi State from their scoreboard. We are not interested in this business. We are not interested in this marketing.
Oh, hold on, sir. Let me just interject. Are you referring to the pandemic COVID-19 as the business, or you're referring to something else?
I am referring to the handling of COVID-19 as a business, not to COVID-19 itself. The way they are handling it, the way they are shortening our economy, and people are dying of hunger, and there is increase in the rate of criminality across the country because of the way the pandemic was mismanaged. That is what I mean by the business. So they should stop the business, stop the marketing, and stop undue publicity of a virus that could be effectively managed. That is what we are saying.
All right, before we move on to other issues, I want to understand this person that you said had a bee sting attack that is being referred to as COVID-19. Has the person come up to speak before the camera to verify these claims you're making. Have you had conversations with this person? And have you had an independent assessment of the situation that gave rise to your position?
I make bold to say here that a lot of people are even afraid of speaking up. But as a government, we've had conversations with the chief imam, and he had spoken to us and gave us his own side of the story. That was why we came out as a government to speak on his behalf, because he is our citizen. Even myself, I've received a lot of threat calls from people who are accusing me of exposing what is happening in NCDC. But we are undaunted. We are fighting for the common man on the street. We are fighting to defend the health integrity of our people. So we are undaunted. We are going to keep fighting, and we are going to keep enlightening our people to the fact that COVID-19 is not as deadly as these people are marketing it, and COVID-19 cannot and should never be a reason why we shut down our economy.
But Honorable Commissioner, if I may ask, your position on this matter is very strong, and you are convinced of that position. Wouldn't it give more credence to your position? I mean, let other Nigerians see your point of view. If the government, as the chief security officer in the state, can guarantee the security of these men, or this man rather, who you say had a bee sting, so he can actually speak up, protect him, so he can actually speak up and, you know, verify the claims that you make.
These are very clear issues. They say there was an index case in the States and declared the man positive of COVID-19. They also said the man's son also had COVID-19. But the son was going to the market and going to eateries to buy food for his dad. And so they knew it all along. NCDC knew it. I think it's more the responsibility of Nigerians to stand up and demand accountability from NCDC. And I think that is where we are going. As to the man, he has the freedom to face the camera or not. We are not going to force him to do that. But we have told the world revelations of our conversations with the man.
All right, let's move on to other developments in Kogi State. What is your reaction to the court ruling affirming Senator Smart Adeyemi's victory?
It is a confirmation of the November 16 revolution. The victory of the All Progressive Congress and Senator Smart Adeyemi was stolen at the first ballot in February. Then the court affirmed that they were stolen and annulled the election of Senator Milaye. We had a rerun election on November 16th, and APC won convincingly. What the tribunal has done today is to confirm what everybody knew all along, that it was a convincing victory on the part of the All Progressive Congress. So I urge the senator to keep working assiduously for the progress of the senatorial district. It is all congratulations for Kogi State.
Okay, I think some clarification will be necessary now. Can you confirm that there was indeed an attack in Isanlu and Kogi Abuja border area where a policeman was said to have been killed, and what the government is doing to unravel the situation?
Yeah, thank you very much. There was an attack in Isanlu, which occurred last week. Immediately, government swung into action. A high-powered delegation led by the deputy governor of the state went to have on-the-spot assessment of what happened there. Security agencies were charged by the governor to ensure that the perpetrators were apprehended and brought to book. Government also went ahead to donate the sum of 10 million naira to families of the victims. And we are very sure that security agencies are on top of the situation, and they will surely apprehend the perpetrators. As to the one on the Abuja Lokoja Road, it is still in the realm of speculations. We had unconfirmed reports there were attacks on that route today. We are expecting the police to come up with their reports. But as a state government, we've beefed up security along the road so that commuters are very safe. But it is instructive to state here that some of the things we are witnessing now are products of the post-pandemic, where families were locked in their homes, absence could not work, and all of that poverty level increasing, hunger increasing. These are the direct effects of what we are seeing. And it is time to stop. I would not want to use some strong words there, but it will be time to stop all of this.
And I really would want to take you on more when you say post-COVID-19, if we've actually gone off the situation, but we are out of time on the news. We will definitely be speaking with you again on a situation in Kogi State. Thank you so much, Commissioner, for your time.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.